Please don't be frightened. There's no one else. Only me. I just want to talk to you. As a woman. Perhaps we could have a cup of tea? I'm here because I worry about you, all of you. I can't stop thinking about the situation you're in here. And I know something about you all that perhaps the others don't. I know that when you met Roch, each one of you separately, you fell completely in love with him. Because he saw who you really were. He saw your loneliness and longing, your lack of direction, your sorrow and anxiety. He saw you, and he loved you because of and in spite of who you were. He promised to cherish you and protect you forever. He promised to show you the way. With only one small condition. That you give yourself over to him completely. You surrender yourself to his love, his vision, his genius. And even early on, before the physical violence, he could look at you with such cold contempt. It was like a knife in the heart. Always judging you for what you wore. Contrary opinion, the way you put butter on the toast in the morning. And so the fear begins, doesn't it? Fear that he'll stop loving you. Throw you out of the safety net that he's wrapped you in. Fear that makes you walk on eggshells, watching and listening for the slightest hint of disapproval or annoyance. Always tense. Afraid that you're going to say or do the wrong thing at the wrong time. And the first time he actually hits you. It's a relief. And afterwards, he's so sorry. And his declarations of love are so sincere. Yes, you love him more than ever. Loving him is your life's work. And so it goes on. The beatings get worse, his odd sadistic pleasures. He hurts and manipulates your children and he turns them against you. He keeps you underfed and underslept and overworked. And some days you don't even know your own name.
Paula, how do you know all these things?
I know because I've been there. I was married to a man like Roch. I was beaten senseless more times than I can remember. And through it all, I still thought, he loves me. He really loves me. This I know. And then one day, I understood. He didn't love me. He didn't know me at all. He was just in love with my fear of him. And without it, he was nothing. No one. And I realized then that I'd rather be dead than spend another second with him. I wasn't afraid anymore. I was free. Speak of the devil.
You stupid bitch. I should kill you.
You're trespassing on my property, trying to steal my things.
These aren't things, Roch. They're human beings. They're not things.
I will kill you. And nobody's ever going to find you.
Then what's stopping you? Go ahead. Look, get your knives over there. Nine poker, take your pick. You see? I'm not afraid of him. I'm not afraid, so he can't hurt me. He's not Moses. He's not God. He's just another fucking asshole.
Please, get out now. Go, go. For us.